السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي خلق فأبدع ما خلق، لا تنفعه طاعة من أطاع ولا تضره معصية من فسق. خلق السماوات والأرض رتقا ثم فتق بقدرته ما رتق. أقسم جل جلاله بالشفق والليل وما وسق والقمر إذا اتسع، وأقسم سبحانه لتركبن طبقا عن طبق، ثم قال فما لهم لا يؤمنون. أسأل الله نجعلنا وإياكم من المؤمنين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف من حق من بالحق نطق، روحي وأبي وأمي ونفسي ومن فدى عليه الصلاة والسلام. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. I would start by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most almighty, the most exalted subhanahu wa ta'ala, and bestowing peace and blessings be upon our most beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Amma ba'd, we are still contemplating and trying to dive in depth into the oceans of the Quranic verses, and in particular Surah Al-Kahf. Someone would say, how come we would spend 4 episodes for Surah Al-Kahf? We may spend 4 million years and we will never exhaust the verses in Surah Al-Kahf, nor in any surah of the Holy Quran. يعني بعض الناس يظن أن 4 لقاءات وما زلنا في سورة الكهف، والله كل ما قرأتها حتى اليوم أنا أقرأ أقول سبحان الله. يعني لا يعرف الإنسان أين يقف. والله I was reciting this surah even yesterday, just going through the pages of the Quran. I said to myself, I can't, والله I can't fulfill the meanings in one ayah, just to spend and talk about this verse in all aspects, comprehensively. Wallahi, I can't. And no one can. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summarized that in the last verse in Surah Al-Kahf. You will find me repeating myself in this because we need to understand, not to just to have a superficial knowledge about the contemplation, about the pondering over its verses. فعلا نحتاج أن نقف، because يعني لأننا الآن في عبادة، كلنا في عبادة نريد أن نصل إلى مرحلة أن نقول يا ربي بذلنا وسعنا في أن نعرف كيف نتدبر. At least just all of these episodes have been designed just to understand, or to just say, Ya Allah, we have done something toward the major obligation that you have put upon us, which is the tadabbur, which is the reflection. Because then again, you will find many people who are hafiz of the Quran, but they never tasted the flavor of the Quran. For example, I was just reading the first 7 verses, and as we discussed before, كما قلنا من قبل أحبتي أن القرآن خذ أي صورة، واليوم إن شاء الله سنتكلم بشيء من سنن تفصيل، لكن مرور الكرام حينما تقرأ أي صورة في القرآن، مجرد أن تنظر إلى صدر الصورة الأول، any surah in the Holy Quran, this applies in all of the surahs of the Holy Quran. When you just read the beginning of the surah, you will know what you will see throughout the surah. ستعرف ماذا ستقابل في الصورة كلها. It's like, more likely, like an abstract. يعني, in scientific researches, في الأوراق العلمية تلقى فيه تمهيد في البداية. يعطيك, تقرأ التمهيد هذا تعرف ماذا سترى في الصورة, في البحث. بعدين تقرأ البحث بالتفاصيل، ثم تكون الخاتمة يعني تعطيك ماذا قرأت والخلاصة. But these are the researches from the human beings. We'll give you the abstract, and you will see the abstract is just an introduction about what you will see throughout the surah, and then the conclusion will cap, you know, wrap up things, صح? But these are the words of people, of mankind, when it comes to the Most Almighty, the Creator of the creation, the King of the Kings, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, something is amazing. Anyone can just tell me what is the first seven ayat in Surah Al-Kahf talks about? Anything, throw anything. Anything? Alhamd lillah, I mean tawheed. I'm praising Allah alone, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Then, Al-Qur'an. Al-Qur'an, صح? الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا. طيب؟ وبعده؟
قرآن قيم.
قرآن قيم. Just praising or complimenting the Qur'an. بعدين؟ لينذر. لينذر. إنذر to warn whoever disbelieve. صح؟ ويبشر. Give glad tidings to those who fulfill the two criteria, ويبشر المؤمنين. It's not enough to be a believer and to claim that you are a believer. You need to prove. You need to prove that. صح? So يبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات. صح? أن لهم أجرا حسنا. Then the reward for those people. صح? جزاؤهم. But كم سيمكثون في هذا الجزاء? How long will they stay in this glad tidings and this happy life and joy? ماكثين فيه أبدا. That means eternal. It's endless. صح? يا ربي نسألك الخلود في الفردوس الأعلى والدين المطهرين المسلمين. وش بعد؟ ماذا بعد؟ What is next? We are still in the fifth almost, fifth آية. اتخذ الله ولدا. Then the same, the warning about those who have gone astray. كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم. يقول amazing word. It's just a heavy word. Which they say when they say Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, the Most Exalted, the Most High, the Almighty, has a son. Subhanahu wa Taala, تعالى علوم كبيرة. I don't want to, you know, every now and then I just come across any word I just want to deviate. Just, anyway, let's concentrate. What else? One thing is remaining there. Tells you about the truth of the worldly life, صح? إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا مَعَلَى الْأَرْضِ زِينَةً لَهَا. Why? لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ. All of this life, all of this worldly life, has one purpose, one main purpose. لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ. So we test it. لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Then, all the wildlife, palaces, the lands. وَإِنَّا لَجَاعِلُونَ مَا عَلَيْهَاً. We will make all what is upon the face of the earth صَعِيدًا جُوزًا. We will level it down to the ground. By just looking at this, you would see the same thing is explained in a different ways. تلك كل هذه الأشياء الأمور ذكرناها مذكورة في القرآن مرة تارة بقصة يبين لك هذه المعالم وهذه الأمور الأساسية في عن طريق القصص وعن طريق المواعظ وعن طريق. So it will come throughout the surah in different forms. Then at the end of the surah, tell me about the last page. What will you see? قَالَ هَذَا. When the Qarnayn looked at that major building that he has done, amazing building. قَالَ هَذَا رَحْمَةً. رَحْمَةٌ مِّن رَبِّي. Then it will say, فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعْدُ رَبِّي جَعَلَهُ دَكَّا وَإِنَّا لَجَعْلُونَ مَا عَلَيْهَا صَعِيدًا جُرُزًا. صح؟ Then we mentioned in the who disbelieve, the one who disbelieve. Then the explanation comes here. وَتَرَكْنَا, I'll tell you what will happen. What about these warnings that I have told you in the beginning of the surah? I will tell you just some live scene that you can just, like while you're reciting these sayings, like if you're saying them in front of your before your eyes. وَتَرَكْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذِ يَمُوجُ فِي بَعْضٍ. This is the warning, this is the way, what they will see, those who disbelieve. What's about that? وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ. Explanation. وَجَمَعْنَا فَجَمَعْنَاهُمْ جَمْعًا وَعَرَضْنَا جَهَنَّمَ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Those who claimed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sunk. لاحظ الآن؟ وإن رجعنا معايا صعيدا جرزا ويأتيك الآن وينذر الذين قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا with these punishments. ها؟ طيب ماذا بعدها؟ بعد هذا الإنذار إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات. هناك ويبشر الذين المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات. صح؟ الآن إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا. How long will they stay? كم يذكر؟ هناك لابثين فيها أبدا؟ ماكثين فيه أبدا؟ هنا خالدين فيها. Do they want to be removed? Do they want to change the place? لا يبغون عنها حولا. اللهم اجعلنا من أهلها. اللهم اجعلنا من أهلها. Then you see the four or the five elements there. If you go within the surah, you will see these aspects have been applied and abide by or not being abide by some people. And you will have the dwelling, al-maskan, al-ma'wa, al-nihai, the ultimate place where each group, each category go. نسأل الله الصلاة والإعانة يا رب العالمين. So in this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you about the truth of that, where they lie. He tells you that whenever you do righteous deeds, I will never put you down. Whether you're wealthy, whether you're healthy, whether you're poor, whatever your status is, I will never put you down. أعطانا الله حقيقة في بداية السورة قال سبحانه وتعالى ويبشر المؤمنين. أحقق الثنتين. Once you fulfill the two criteria, you will be never put down. لن مستحيل تتعامل مع رب العالمين وتخسر. مستحيل. والله إنه أعز وأعظم وأكرم وأجل من أن يخذل من صدق معه. لأجل هذا أعطانا الله سبحانه وتعالى هذه القضية، هذه الحقيقة، this fact. ثم أعطانا أقوام مختلفين في أموالهم وصحتهم وسلطتهم. Allah has given us this fact. Then Allah has given us those people who fulfill these two criteria, irrespective to their status, whether they are wealthy, healthy, whatever, regardless, irrespective. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He explained this, because He doesn't want anyone to come and say, oh ya Allah, I want to fulfill these two criteria, but I was poor, I was weak, I was under stress, under oppression. صح؟ Or you may say, Wallahi ya Allah, I would love to fulfill this criteria, and yet Allah's having lots of wealth and health, and I can't with such a busy life to fulfill these two things. I was a king. I was busy. I was a CEO. Allah has given you in the same surah, even if you were a king. I will give you an example for someone who was in the same position, yet he fulfilled the two criteria. Shall we start? The three stories which we have discussed in the last episode, يعني بغض النظر عن حالتك إذا حققت الشرطين المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات. Because we discussed in the previous episodes that there are some people who say that we are a believer, نحن مؤمنون. Yet they don't prove that with actions. صح؟ يقول مؤمن. ولأجل هذا قال الله سبحانه وتعالى ألف لامين أحسب الناس. Do mankind, do people believe أن يتركوا, to be left alone, أن يقولوا آمنا, by just saying we are believers, وهم لا يفتنون, and they will be just left alone without any test. ولقد فتن الذين من قبلهم. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said ذلك بأنهم قالوا آمنا بأفواههم, by the tips of their lips and the tips of their tongues they said آمنا. وَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ قُلُوبُهُمْ, but their hearts never believed. They say it. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always, in the entire Quran, when He subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the iman, you will find وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ immediately there. تَصْرِيحًا أَوْ تَلْمِيحًا, i.e. direct or indirect. Direct, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات, صح؟ المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات. But you will find in one of the verses Allah did not say directly وعملوا الصالحات. In Surah Al-Balad, where Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, تجد دائما آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات, دائما. في بعض الآيات ومنك آية البلد, سورة البلد, لا تجد هيئة صريحا يا تلميحا, لا بد. في سورة العصر, إن الإنسان الذي خسر إن الذين آمنوا وتواصوا, which are good deeds, righteous deeds or not. زكاة الخير رب العالمين. This is another example. So Allah will explain آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات, آمنوا وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. Then you fulfill the four criteria. What about سورة البلد؟ فلا اقتحم العقبة وما أدراك ما العقبة, فك رقبة أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة, يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا. ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا. Because it's this word, amanu, is surrounded before, pre and post of this verses, all are righteous deeds. Because some people believe that when I donate, some people who are wealthy, they think that, mashallah, I donate, I feed the poor, I build mosques. But he's not doing anything, he's not a mu'min, he's not doing good deeds. He's just donating. Allah is telling us that this is not enough. أَجَعَلْتُمْ سِقَايَةَ الْحَاجِ. Even if you built the custody in the Mecca, al-Haram, it's not enough without the iman. It doesn't benefit you. أَجَعَلْتُمْ سِقَايَةَ الْحَاجِ وَعِمَارَةَ النَّاسِ الْحَرَمِ كَمَنْ آمَنَ. Do you think they are the same? Do you get the point? Because some people say, I hope that I built or participate, whether financially or physically, to build al-haram. Allah is telling you, with your iman, you are better than whoever built the entire haram without being a mu'min himself. أَجْعَلْتُمْ سِقَايَةَ الْحَالِ. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَا اَفْتَحَمَ الْعَقَرَ. He will never pass the bridge to the Jannah. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَرَ فَقْقُ رَقَبَ. You free a slave. أو إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ فِي مَسْغَبَ. مَسْغَبَ means the severe hunger. Then you to imagine that someone has traveled all the way by himself and donate and feed all the poor, the hungry people in any part of the world where it's severe poverty. Do you think that this will save him? No. عَمِلَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. But he's not a mu'min himself. صح؟ أَوْ إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْغَبَةٍ يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةٍ. He's taking care of the orphans, any next of kin, orphans, huh? أَوْ مِسْكِينًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةٍ. Again, the poor people. That's not enough. ثم كان من الذين آمنوا. He must be. He must fulfill the two. Is that clear? So when is that enough? You see somebody, oh, mashallah, he's donating all over. He's spreading his money all over the place. No, it's not enough. You yourself, you must be. You must. What is your relationship with Allah? Ya Allah, أصلح أحوالك. So once you fulfill this, Allah will never put you down, and you will never be led astray, and you will never lose. Never, ever. Wallahi. That's why Allah has given us the three stories. The first one, they fulfill. Young people, regardless of how old you are. See, subhanAllah, even the age group, not only the financial status, the socio-economical status, no. Even the age group, wherever, once, يعني أيا كان عمر, ليس أيا كان حالتك الاجتماعية والمالية المادية, لا لا. حتى عمرك, ما دمت قد جاوزت أو بلغت سن التكليف, فأنت حقق الشرطين وخذ الوعد. And the Quran is full with criteria and promises. For criteria and promises. Fulfill the criteria. Wait for the promise. أي آية في القرآن فيها شرط وقبل الشرط وبعد الشرط وعد. مثال: ومن يتق الله شرط. Whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in what he say, what he see, what he hears. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ. What is the promise? يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. أُقْسِمْ بِاللَّهِ مَا تَكُمْ مُتَّقِي ثُمْ لَا يَجْعَلْ اللَّهِ لَكُمْ خَرَجًا. والله العظيم, Allah will get you out of your struggle, out of your hardships. Once you, if you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا رَبِّ جَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يُكَفِّرْ. This is shart. Criteria. يُكَفِّرْ عَنْهُ سَيِّئَاتِ. He will remove from you all your sins. وَيَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسَّرًا. He will ease all affairs in your life. ومن يتق الله, ان تتقوا الله يجعل لكم. تتقوا الله شرط. يجعل لكم فرقانا. You judge on things rightly. Because you may judge on things, but it's not necessary to be, you are right in your judgment. That's why Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام used to pray and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a great supplications. أحيانا تحدد وتقرر, لكن لا يعني أن قرارك صحيح وحكمك صحيح في الأشياء واختياراتك صحيحة. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام يقول: اللهم يا ربي أرنا الحق حقا. Why? Some people يرونه باطلا يعني. Yes, yes. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام asked Allah سبحانه وتعالى: أو يا الله, show me the truth as being the truth. Because some people see the truth as falsehood. صح؟ And act upon that. وَرْزُقْنَا اتِّبَاعَ. And Ya Allah, grant us the best tawfiq to follow that haq, to that truth, to abide by the truth. It's totally different dua. Because you may see al-haq haqqan, but you are not helped by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to follow, to abide by it. And that's true. One of the examples. What is the easiest ibadah in our daily lives?
Dhikr.
Remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't cost you energy, it doesn't cost you money, it doesn't cost you anything. Even doesn't cost you your time, because why? You are doing your things. صح? So it is a truth. How many of us make dhikr as should be? As their clothes. You will never compete with your clothes. Your clothes making dhikr more than you. Way, by far. وَإِن مِن شَيْءٍ everything. إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. Everything is exalting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْهَمُ تَسْبِيحًا. But you don't comprehend the way they are making such tasbih. So, it is not knowing the haqq. It is the tawfiq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the aid, the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the things that is really makes me feel that bad, wallahi, when I remember the ayah when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the hypocrites, the munafiqeen. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى إن المنافقين يخادعون الله وهو خادع وإذا قاموا إلى الصلاة قاموا كسالى يراءون الناس ولا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا. They remember الله سبحانه وتعالى but little. ابن تيمية يقول سبحان الله those are المنافقين and they make ذكر. But Qaleel, how come? Well, we are not even sometimes doing the Qaleel. You get my point? That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, knowing the haq is one thing. Following the haq is blessed. Allah. So, knowing the haq is something. Abiding by the haq, by the truth, is something else. That needs the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this can never be obtained unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator subhanahu wa ta'ala, helps you to do so. So, وَأَيْنَ الْبَاطِلَ بَاطِلًا. Oh Ya Allah, help us see the falsehood as falsehood. وَرْزُقْنَا اجْتِنَابَ. And help us to avoid it. Because sometimes you see the falsehood, yet you follow it. So you need to fulfill the criteria of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who has given you everything. Given you your kidneys, your hearts, your eyes, your blood cells, your immune system. All of them have been given to you by one, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about those young people, young men, who were oppressed by their folks, because the king was unjust, and he was a transgressor, and he wanted to push them out of their deen. Why? Because they worship the Almighty, the Creator alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Did they fulfill the criteria? The belief, the true belief, and the actions upon what they believe. Did they fulfill it? Did they fulfill the criteria?
Yes.
Sah. Then when they fulfill the criteria, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never asked them ask them to do something beyond their capabilities. صح? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never asked them to fight against their people. But what did they say? Who was in a more powerful position? Was it those seven young people, young men, or their folks in terms of power? Their folks, sure, right? Then Allah never asked them, because sometimes you are in a weaker position, yet you say, I have no obligation. No, you still have obligation. That's why they just ask their people to prove the truth for them. To prove it. Sah? Prove it for me. And this is what all the Quran all about. Just talk to me with evidence. That's why, subhanAllah, even with the people of scriptures, i.e. the Jew and Christians, how did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ask us or teach us in the Quran how to deal with them? وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ. Never dispute, argue with the people of scriptures, except بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. Except with the good manner? No. With the bitter manner? No. With the best manner. Why? Because we are just following the truth. Whatever the truth is, we are following it. And the Quran is telling us that never use a word when you discuss with the Christians or the people of scriptures or the Jew, except you choose the best word. Why? Because you are abiding by the commandments of the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what did Allah subhanahu ask us to do? قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ. This is exactly what those young people, they spoke to their folks. They said, لَوْ لَا يَأْتُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِسُلْطَانٍ بَيِّنٍ. We need just a proof. صح? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ. Oh, say, oh, the people of scriptures, تَعَالَوْا. Come. إلى كلمة سواء بيننا وبينكم. Let's come into the common terms between us and yourselves. What are the common terms? ألا نعبد إلا الله. That we worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Creator. Because all of us believe that He is the only one who has given us everything, صح? So, let's come into common terms. أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا. And we never associate any partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. We shall never worship anyone below Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Someone will say, but Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, is the son of God. صح? Look how the Quran tackled this issue. If you want to talk to anyone, don't tell them that you are a liar, you don't know anything. عندما تناقش أحد من النصارى قل له فقط سؤال واحد. And the Quran is amazing when it comes to the aqidah, to the creed. It doesn't talk about these trivial things. الأشياء الثانوية لا يتكلم عن القرآن. يتكلم عن أصل العقيدة. You just can ask anyone. And we are all, guys, as Muslims, how many times we ask Allah for guidance to the right path? The minimum Muslim shall ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 17 times a day. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Ya Allah, guide us to the right path. So we are at the end of the day searching for the truth. صح? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in the Quran. قل إن كان للرحمن ولدا. Tell them, if the most merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had a son, فأنا كافر به فأنا then indeed myself I will worship him? No. فأنا أول العابدين I will be the first to worship him. I will not only worship him, but I will be the first one to worship him. But just let's talk about the evidence. Let's talk about the evidence. Then if you come and ask any of them, just tell him. Tell him, mate, I'm with you now. You can take me with you to the church, but I will be coming, I will even attend more way. By far, I will be more punctual than yourself. I will attend the first one in the church. Yet, just prove it for me with the evidence. If you just ask anyone, just tell me where this notion, had fikr, came from. Just tell me, if you don't mind, just tell me who was the first one who said on the earth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a son. Who was he? Who was he? No one can tell me. I'm telling you now. Who was the first one who said Allah has a son? They would say, okay. Like why? Why would you say that? Because I'm searching for the truth. I'm ready to go with you, but I don't want to go without any evidence. I want to change. I'm ready to change once the evidence is before me. Amen. Right? So one would say, it is logical. Yes, tell me, what is it that is logical? You'd say, everybody, all human beings, came from a mother and a father, right? Except Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him. And that is true. We believe in that in the Holy Quran. Okay, tell me, how is that logical? He said, because Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, was born with a mom, a mother, without a father. That's true. We believe in it. It is in the Quran. But what is the logic now? Someone thought that since Isa alayhi salam has not gotten a father, so we need to look for a father for him. So who's his father? Then they say, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah ulwa kabira. Allah is giving you a very logical discussion. He said, okay. Inna mathal Isa inda Allah ka mathal Adam. And if you have chosen Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, the Almighty, to be the father of Isa alayhi salam because the lack of the father, then what about Adam? He has no father and no mother. Who is more difficult? Adam alayhi salam, right? Because you didn't have the 50%. Sah? Allah is telling us that the one who brought this logic, he didn't play it well. He should have chosen Adam alayhi salam. Because with that, you cannot compete, I mean, in terms of logical rationalization. You get my point? So Allah is telling you that, then if that is just because he didn't have a father, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and these examples, for example, Adam alayhi salam, is existed in the Quran, in the Bible, in the Torah, in all the scriptures. So no one can say, no, I don't believe that Adam is, it is there. And Allah, when Allah gives you the judgment or the argument, he gives it to you with the evidence, with something that both sides believe, but will eliminate this logic, because if that was a true, that had been a truth, then we would have built for every church for Isa alayhi salam, for Jesus, we should have built two churches for Adam alayhi salam. Sah? Sah? Because there is no mother and no father. And 1.5 church for Eve. Hawa. Who was her? Where did she come from? Where is the mother of Hawa? Where is the womb? You got my point? So Allah is giving you, just give me the evidence. Let's discuss about it. We believe in Allah, then why would we associate a partner with Allah? When you bring a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let's discuss it. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا. Only if the people of the scripture believe truly in Allah, in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and fear Allah. لَكَفَّرْنَا عَنْهُمْ سَيِّئَاتٍ. We will wipe off all of their sins. وَلَأَدْخَلْنَاهُمْ جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. And surely we will enter them to the paradise. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ. Only if they had. أَقَامُوا القرآن؟ No. أَقَامُوا التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ. And only if they uphold the Gospel, the Torah, and what is in the Injil, in the Bible, truly they will find only one God. Only one God. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ أَقَامُوا التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ أَوْ whatever has been revealed from their Lord لَأَكَلُوا مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِهِمْ مِنْهُمْ أُمَّةٌ مُقْتَصِدَةٌ وَكَثِيرٌ مِنْهُمْ سَاءَ مَا يَعْمَلُونَ. ثم قال سبحانه, immediate verse, يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ بَلِّغْ مَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. Oh, the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reveal, tell them the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what has been revealed to you from your Lord. وَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلْ, and if you don't, فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَ, then you have not conveyed the true message. Then another amazing ayah comes immediately afterward. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْكَافِرِينَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never guide the disbelieving people. What is the next ayah? قُلْ يَا أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. Oh, say, O people of the scriptures, لَسْتُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ. You stand on nothing. One would say, oh, how is the Quran is telling us to tell them this? No, wait, I complete the ayah. The most polite way. لَسْتُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ. You stand on nothing حَتَّى تُقِيمُ التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ. You claim that you follow the Torah and Injil. I'm telling you that you stand on nothing unless you apply what is in the Gospel and what is in the Bible. For example, if you come to the Christmas, will you find the things, the activities in the Christmas, would you find these mentioned in the Bible? Never. What if Jesus alayhi salam had come and seen and looked at all of these things? Would he say that this is what I taught you in the Bible? He would never say that. So Allah is telling that you, once I claim that I'm following the policy, but I'm doing something else, anyone can come to me and he said, you stand on nothing. Unless you apply what you say that you believe in. صح? Look how amazing the Quran is doing giving the evidence very smoothly, very nicely, very logically. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this next page said, ما المسيح ابن مريم إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل. That Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, was only a messenger of Allah, a beloved messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قد خلت من قبله الرسل. Many messengers had passed away before him. Even more miraculous birth than Isa alayhi salam. I.e. meaning that Adam alayhi salam. وَأُمُّهُ صِدِّيقَةٌ. And his mother was the most pious woman on the face of earth. كَانَا يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. انظر نبين لهم الآيات ثم انظر أنى يؤفكون. سبحان الله. Allah is saying that Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, was only a beloved messenger. Before him had many messengers, and his mom was a pious person. They were eating food. Subhanallah. Someone would say, okay, what does that mean? They were eating food. And then afterward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they were eating food. Look how we made our verses clear to them. Someone would say, what is the clarity in it? Because they were eating food, is that? They were eating food. Look how we make clear our verses to them. And look, then umbo, how they are deluded away. Subhanallah. What is in it that is making clear for us? Because they were eating food? Yes. What is the natural process after eating food? You digest it. And you utilize only some portion of the food. The other portion will go away, right? Is that an attribute that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala possess, a God possess, or a human being possess? So Allah is giving you now the two arguments, the two evidence that Isa alayhi salam, Jesus peace and blessings be upon him, was one of the most beloved messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ulil Azm wa Rasul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created everyone, all mankind. And he, among them, he has chosen al-anbiya, the prophets. Min al-anbiya, from among us, the prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen al-rusul, the messengers. Sah? And among the messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen five, Ulul Azm min al-rusul. And among the five, Allah has chosen Ibrahim alayhi salam, Khalilullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Ibrahim alayhi salam is the common messenger that everyone is believing in. That's why the Jew would say Ibrahim alayhi salam was a Jew. And Christian would say Ibrahim alayhi salam was a Jew. And Muslims claim that Ibrahim was Muslim. And the Quran said, مَا كَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ يَهُودِيًّا وَلَا نَصْرَانِيًّا وَلَكِنْ كَانَ حَنِيفًا مُسْلِمًا. He was not associating anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet he was Hanif. He believed in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the monotheism of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, it's just all about the evidence. And one of the conferences in Egypt, it was just about the religions, okay? And a Jew was invited, a Muslim was invited, a Christian was invited, I mean scholars, preachers, priests, rabbi, okay? And when they were at the stage, the Muslim said to the Jew, you just start talking. The Jew said, no, let's the Christian start. And everyone was saying, let this individual start first. And then they just say, okay, we are in Egypt, and the majority are Muslims, so just start. Oh, a Muslim scholar, just start. He said, I would just say very concise statements. قال الله يعني لازم ترجم بالعربي لأن المرة الماضية زعلوا الناس. I must translate in Arabic because some people were not happy because they said we did not comprehend all what you said in English. So I need to mix up the two, just make, you know. May Allah help me. Just looking at the time because Sheikh Ibrahim is looking at me. You know, for about 4 minutes here, you can cut. Anyway, الاجتماع المؤتمر هذا كان في مسلمين وفيها يهود وفي نصارى وكان النقاش حول الأديان فكان كل واحد من العلماء يعزم الثاني فاتفقوا أن المسلم يتكلم فرس The Muslim scholar, he said, look, if it comes in the judgment day, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the Jew were correct, and everyone else is not correct, I will go with the Jew to Jannah to the Paradise. He said, why? Because he said, I believe in Moses alayhi salam. And if it happened that the Christians are the one in truth, I will go with them. Because I believe in Jesus, peace and blessings upon him. And look at the Quran, how is he complimenting Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, peace and blessings upon him. But you guys, if I was in the truth, you would be in trouble. Because you don't believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Although they came with the same thing, with the one thing, but these books have been modified. And you can never, with scientific proofs, prove that the Quran has another edition or some modifications. You can see when any imam leading the salat, leading the prayer, when he made just a slight mistake, everyone will come and say, oh, come back. Or even if it's a letter. So those people, those young men, they said the truth. And that's it. Then, where did they go? Did they fight? They escaped to worship Allah alone. They said, oh, those folks had not given us any proof that our belief is wrong. That we follow the logic, even. We follow the one whom we believe that he has created everything. So you have no excuse if you have less power not to fulfill those two criteria. Iman and Amal Saleh, the belief and the action. Sahih. What about the second story in the same surah, in the same chapter? The man of the two gardens, sah? And the other man, who was a mu'min, who was a believer, and acting upon what he believes, sah? Sah? But in terms of power, who is stronger? They are both, apart from the health and wealth. And he didn't say, I'm powerful than you. And I have more sons and more wealth. And I have more wealth. Sah? How did the man react? He said, did you deny the one who has created you? Did you disbelieve that? He said, I am the one who has my wealth, I am the one who has obtained this with my power, with my thinking, with my experience. He said, do you deny the one who has given you everything? Subhanallah. What is in common between the two? The young men in the first surah and this man in the second surah. What is the common thing?
Believing in God.
Believing in God alone and acting accordingly and spreading the message of Allah very clearly. That how would you, those young men, they said to their folks, to their people, how would you disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by associating partners with them? If you ask me who has given me my kidneys, I would not say one has been given by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the other one has given to me by Allah. Sah? Both kidneys have been given to me by Allah. What about the heart? What about the lungs? What about the brain? What about the trillions of neurons? What about the 2.4 millions of nephrons in my kidneys? Dialyzing day and day night. All of them, so it's logically to obey him, worship him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, they are doing the same thing in common. What about the third story about Musa Ali? No, Dhulqarnayn. Because Musa alayhi salam and Khidr, they both were believing in Allah, there is no problem. What about the surah of Dhulqarnayn, the king, with his folks, with his people, who was having the more power? And Khidr, Dhulqarnayn, right? What did he do? He was just fair. Was he saying anything to his people? أَمَّا مَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. So there is something in common, right? So regardless of your level of power, of authorities, you need to fulfill the criteria. What are the criteria? Amanu, you believe and you act accordingly. And one of the one form of the action in accordance to what Allah, what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to tell the message, to convey the message. So regardless of where you are, the position where you are in, you must fulfill these criteria and deliver the message correctly. Allah will never ask you more than what you can do, what you're capable of doing. The three stories have talked about journeys. صح? The young people had a journey. And Musa alayhi salam had a journey. And Dhul Qarnayn had a journey as well. صح? All the three journeys have something in common. All of them for the sake of Allah. All of them seeking the countenance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Escaping from the oppression. Why? Because they want to obey Allah, to worship Allah. Having a prolonged trip, Moses alayhi salam, to increase his knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhul Qarnayn had journey all over the world to spread the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to protect anyone who is under oppression. Ya'juj wa Ma'juj mufsiduna fil ard. Hal naj'al laka kharja ala taj'al bayna wa bayna hadma? Sadda? Those people, they don't speak the language of Dhul Qarnayn. Did Dhul Qarnayn say, I can't understand you, so Allah will never ask me why I didn't protect you, so I don't care. I don't understand you. No. في قراءة لا يكادون يفقهون قولا. That they don't even comprehend what Dhul Qarnayn was saying. وفي قراءة لا يكادون يفقهون قولا. They speak a language that is very strange. No one can understand them. That's why they said that more than 20 interpreters were interpreting to each other until they interpreted to the way that Abdul Qarnayn can comprehend what they are saying. Did he help them? He came through all the different situations of people and he never moved or bounced by any region unless he spread the justice and helping the poor. So regardless of where your position, you can please the only one God subhanahu wa ta'ala. صح? So three stories and three age group and three conditions having the same thing in common. If you go in between these stories, you will always find the five things that we discussed in the first and the end of the surah. Read it tonight or tomorrow. You will find Al-Quran, for example, when the story of the young people, when it finishes, what did Allah subhanahu say? If you want to have the same iman, وَاتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ أَنْزَلَ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ الْكِتَابِ. صح؟ And at the end, قُلْ لَوْ كَانُ بَحْرُ مِدَادَ لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّكَ. صح؟ وَاتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. Then recite what has been revealed to you from your Lord. لا مبدل لكلماته.
No changer to his words.
Look at the protection. Throughout the years, no one can modify any verse. لا مبدل لكلماته ولن تجد من دونه ملتحدا. Never will you find an other than him a refuge. لن تجد من دونه ملتحدا. واصبر نفسك. Be patient with the people الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهه. Those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be patient with them, regardless of their situation. ولا تعد عيناك عنهم. Let not your eyes pass beyond them. تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا, looking for the tournament of the worthy life. ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا. وأخذ الحق من ربكم. Then say it, say the truth. Regardless, did the young people say the truth? Did the man who was discussing with the man of the two gardens this, tell the truth? Dhul Qarnayn, tell the truth. وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ. Don't never force anyone. Never force anyone. Whoever wants to believe, but the most important thing that you tell the truth. Have we told the truth in our departments? Have we told the truth with the people whom we live with? We need to fulfill these things. Ya Allah. Just tell it. وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ نَارًا أَحَاطَ بِهِمْ سُرَادِقُهَا لِيُنذِرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا. At the beginning, صح؟ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Indeed, for those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ and acted accordingly, إِنَّا لَا نُضِيعُ أَجْرًا أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. They will never be wrong. وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. At the beginning, right? So all the things will be told in the same story and will be mentioned between the stories, except the story of Musa al-Khidr. There were no comments about these five things because they are implemented within the story, and they were both sides were mu'min, were believers. You see how amazing the Quran is? So any story that contains or comprises two parties, believing and non-believing parties, there will be a revision of what has been mentioned in the first of the surah, of the chapter. Subhanallah, we have passed the time that has been indicated by Shaykh Ibrahim. So inshallah we will continue inshallah in the next episode. It might be inshallah 1 month from now, because I might not be in the UK in 2 weeks' time. Allah knows best. But inshallah, I will do that. But I will just conclude with something very amazing in the surah, if you don't mind. Please, guys, we always say, I'm coming, and just wait for me. Can you come next week? Yes? Sure. Oh. Don't say sure, please. Don't say sure. Because to say that you are sure, you need first to prove that you will be alive at that time. صح? And secondly, the other person who is waiting for you must be alive. صح? Thirdly, the subject of the meeting must be existed as well. صح? You own nothing, none of them. That's why you need to be polite with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever we say, I will come, just say, God willing, inshallah. Because I do not. I don't own my heart. So I can buy and purchase more beats. So by doing so, please, whenever you give any promise, say, inshallah. Keep the promise. You must keep the promise as being taught in the Quran. But you must say, inshallah, that God willing. Because unless he,
By doing so, you will see even your iman strengthening, because you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the more you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more likely you will thank Him and praise Him. And the more you praise Him, the more likely you will worship Him. Allahumma inna ala dhikrika wa ala shukrika wa ala husni ibadatik. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقنا وإياكم لهداه وأن يجعل عملنا وإياكم في رضاه. اللهم يا رب أعنا على ما يرضيك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، فإننا لا نملك لأنفسنا نفعا ولا ضرا. اللهم يا رب أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا، وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا، وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا. اللهم إنا نسألك بأن عبيدك بنو عبيدك بنو إمائك، نواصينا بيدك، ماض فينا حكمك، عدل فينا قضاؤك. نسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحد من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك، أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا. اللهم يا من بيدك الدنيا والآخرة، اللهم أوزعنا أن نشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علينا وعلى والدينا، وأن نعمل صالحا ترضاه، وأصلح لنا في ذرياتنا، وأدخلنا برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين. اللهم اجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، والموت راحة لنا من كل شر. نسألك من الخير كله، عاجله وآجله، أوله وآخره، ظاهره وباطنه، ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله، عاجله وآجله، أوله وآخره، ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم يا ربي ارحم والدينا كما ربونا صغارا، اللهم ارحم أموات المسلمين عامة يا ربي، وأمواتنا خاصة يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل قبورهم رياض من رياض الجنة، اللهم اجعل قبورهم رياض من رياض الجنة، وبلغهم الفردوس الأعلى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين أجمعين. اللهم اهدنا كافة من حضر من الإنس والجن وغيرهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه بإذنه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. آسف حبتي على الإطالة، أستغفر الله لي ولكم، جزاك الله عنا خير الجزاء.
جزاكم الله خير دكتور، بارك الله فيك. Now the questions will start with the brother Abu Bakr. The subject.
My question is based on Zohar Nayib. Do you think we can have a leader like Zohar Nayib in the future because of the situation that we are right now and the kind of leaders that we have?
Allahu Akbar. You mean Zohar Nayib? Our beloved brother Abu Bakr, he is asking, can we have another leader like Zohar Nayib who would spread justice? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us all the tools to succeed. Yet, and all the tools, wherever you are, if you are a prisoner, you find a good example in the Quran, like Yusuf alayhi salam. Sah? If you are a king, you have a good example for you, Dhulqarnayn and other anbiya who were kings. If you are poor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jesus peace and blessings be upon him, most of the anbiya were poor. So you can't say, I don't have an example. Yet, this is not enough. Sah? To answer your question. Yet, that's why Al-Mahdi will come and fill the earth with justice until Mahdi formed the Shia. And the true Mahdi that was indicated and described by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also, there will be another one who was Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, whom we believe that he was not crucified. We believe that he was taken to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will come at the end of the days and he will rule the earth on the monotheism, on the tawheed, and the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with no associate. Hope that answers your question.
Another question.
في مواضع كثيرة ذكرت
جزاك الله خير الله يسلمك
ذكرت كلمة المتقين الذين يتقون الذين آمنوا واتقوا
الله أكبر
الابتغاء مرحلة ممكن الإنسان يصلب يتبع خطوات معينة.
يا سلام.
وهل الإنسان ممكن يعرف نفسه هو متقي ولا لا؟
يا سلام. يا سلام. يا سلام. يا سلام. Our beloved brother is asking about the different levels of in the religion itself. Being a Muslim, surrendering yourself and submitting yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a wider and the minimum expectation of a human being. There is a stage just above that, which is al-mu'minun, the true believers. Then there is another level, which is al-muttaqun, the pious people. And there is a higher level where people can compete, which is al-ihsan. A very high way, a high way of life that was described by Nabi alayhi salatu was salam, and ta'bud Allah, whoever is in this stage, in this level, in this high level, and ta'bud Allah, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, like if they are seeing Him. And even in their worst case scenario, they worship Allah like if He sees them subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. Al-Ihsan darajtayn, kama qal al-Qayyim, two levels. Al-Ihsan is divided into two levels. The first level that you obey Allah, you worship Allah in a way that like if you are seeing Allah when you're saying your words, when you're seeing things, when you're hearing some things, when you're acting. Like if you are seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only by fear, by fearing Him, no. By just such a way of respect that cannot be described. And then when their belief has decreased a little bit, they will reach the second level of ihsan, which is like if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees them all the time. So what is the difference between tiqa, as Shaykh said? He asked, what is the difference between the things and how can I rate myself? How can I rank myself? Which rank am I suitable for? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described, if you are doing the five pillars of Islam, then you are a Muslim. If you pray, fast, give zakah, making hajj, you witness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last messenger, and that he's his servant and last messenger, then you are a Muslim. You are a Muslim. No one can say that you're the Muslim. But the Iman is another stage. يؤمنون الإيمان بالله. This can be discussed in a separate episode, but yet I just try to describe it very fast, inshallah. And تؤمن بالله, that you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does الإيمان بالله? الإيمان بالله, how many pillars? Six pillars. The first one, and تؤمن بالله. What does تؤمن بالله? Does it mean that you believe that he's existed? No, this is not a belief. Fir'aun even, Fir'aun, he believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. آمنت بالذي آمنت به من المسلمين. صح؟ Even Iblis, the devil. He said, بعزتك. صح؟ So it is not, you just go with the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That you believe that He sees you everywhere. You believe that He is able to help you wherever your situation is. You believe in that. No one can know. When you say, for example, if I say, here is the army, 1,000 soldiers with you, protecting you. A believer without these 1,000, he feels more comfortable than you. Because he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with him now. You get my point? It's a belief that will reveal a comfort, a rejoice by its own. You believe in the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the young men of Al-Kahf, the people of Al-Kahf, they believed in that. إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا. He didn't say أَسْلَمُوا.
آمنوا. When they believe, they just ask Allah, يا الله ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة. Oh, يا الله, grant us from yourself mercy. وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. And يا الله, oh God, oh our Lord, prepare for us from all our affairs a guidance. All your affairs? Yes, all our affairs. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was with them when they were in the cave. Who took care of them from A to Z? 300 years. And when they slept, and when they woke up, nothing was changed. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He wants to stop your cells from asking for nutrition, He can, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When He asks subhanahu wa ta'ala your blood cells to work without oxygen and nutrients, He can do it. So this is the iman. When you believe in the unseen, that there is something, how can you? Iman is increasing and decreasing. The more good deeds you do, the more you have the iman. The more you contemplate on the Quran, the more iman. Who said so? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said so. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ. Whenever Allah is mentioned, they will remember, oh, if I donate a kidney for you, you will never forget me. So they never forget who has given the kidney. When Allah is mentioned, their hearts will start beating. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ. Because they are paying attention to the verses, زَادَتْهُمْ إِمَانًا. So you can ask yourself, am I a mu'min? How many verses have I heard? And how many of these verses have had an impact on me? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. You can assess yourself, am I really humbly submissive in my prayers? وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّهُ مُعْرِضُونَ. They will never hear bad words from them. So am I allowing myself to say bad words? Then my level of iman needs a revision. You get my point? So if you are striving with your Islam to be a mu'min, Allah will get you there. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. And when you're striving in the iman, Allah will give you the taqwa, the piety. Who said so? And when you strive in the piety to be a muhsin, Allah will get you there. Who said so? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَعَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ جُنَاحٌ فِي مَا طَعِمُوا إِذَا مَا اتَّقَوْا. They are in the level of taqwa. Between taqwa and iman. إِذَا مَا اتَّقَوْا وَآمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. If they are pious, whenever they say something, they will say, okay, where does this word will go? In my good deeds or in my bad deeds? In misdeeds. Like when Umar al-Khattab was asked, he asked people, he said, what does taqwa mean? What does piety mean? Then one of the companions said, oh yeah, Amir al-Mu'min, have you ever walked in a place where it is full with thorns, broken glasses, and misses on the ground? He said, yes. He said, what did he do? He said, I watch out. I was very careful where to put my feet. He said, be careful where to put your words. Be careful what you hear. Everything, just like, treat it like a danger and avoid it. This taqwa means al-khawfu min al-jareeb. Many definitions. الخوف من الجليل والعمل بالتنزيل والرضا بالقليل والاستعداد للمراحل. So if you are really watching yourself, watching what you see, watching what you say, watching what you hear, then you are muttaqi. Let's go back to the ayah. أينما اتقوا وآمنوا وعملوا الصالحات ثم اتقوا وآمنوا في أصحابهم ثم أحسن الله يحب المحسنين. They are striving in every level to reach the other level. And whenever you sincerely search for the truth or heading to a new, a higher level of Iman, wallahi, Allah will give it to you. For example, how many of us would complain that they don't have such a great feeling in their prayers? Khushu'. I will ask you a very simple question that I asked myself. How much have you done to obtain this level? How many prostration you pray that, Ya Allah, لم أخشى منك. يا الله يا رب الثانية يا ذلك. Oh, Ya Allah, I missed this rak'a. I didn't feel it. Ya Allah. Why are you prostrating? Ya Allah. When you donate something, Ya Allah. حتى نخشى. Ya Allah. And how much do we do for every level? Allah will never put you down if you are truly, sincerely asking for the next upper level. So, the muttaqun, we can, inshallah, dedicate a separate, inshallah, episode for these attributes for each, and how can I, from the Quran, how can I evaluate myself? That's why in the Quran, Allah has given us all the details how to reach the next upper level. Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. هو أرض الذين يؤمنون به ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. So, the Quran is full with attributes that will tell you where you are and how to be there. وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يوفقنا ويقيمنا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الشيخ السيد جزاه الله خير. Does that mean that in Ramadan, during Ramadan, the month of Ramadan, we are practicing a level of ihsan? Yes. But you need to keep that level that you have on the day, even after the Maghrib. For example, if while you're fasting, when I bring you a cup of water and I say, drink that and I'll give you £1 billion. Just drink it. Will you do it?
No.
Wallahi, you don't do it. What if it was £2 billion? Wallahi, I will never do it, illa inshaAllah. What if I say I'll give you 50 billions? You will not do it. If I ask you why, it is not alcohol, it is just water. You say, no, because I strongly believe that when I take this, the first drop of water that will go down through my esophagus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees it. And I now consider to be violating what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm fasting for the sake of Allah. So Allah is telling you that, how come you reject a water for 5 billion and then you will cheat people for £10? You see, Ramadan is a course, an intensive course for you, telling you that I am there. I see you. Many people, they will reject the water in the day and they will drink in the night. They avoid something that is halal, permissible. That's why, inshallah, the next episode we will talk about the beauty of Islam that deals with you physically, spiritually, and comprehensively. That's why sometimes we do things, wallahi, if we feel it, I swear by God, your entire life will change. The taste will be added to your daily life, to every action you do. That's why you are muhsin if you are practicing the fast. Allah, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyamu kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum. He didn't say la'allakum tuj'u. He said, oh believer, the fasting has been commanded from you as it has been commanded for the other people of the scriptures before you. Huh? لَعَلَّكُمْ. So you will be not Muslimin, not ja'in, hungry. So I want to test your hungry, your tolerance. No. لعلكم تتقون.
Now you are rejecting, you are practicing your taqwa with the water. And no one can force you.
Quran, the Ramadan is teaching you how to say, I'm strong. I have rejected water for the sake of Allah. How didn't you want me to reject something that is harmful for me?
I am strong. I'm really powerful. And this is what the course of Ramadan will give you. It will get you to the next upper level with the support of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hope that answers your question.
JazakAllah khair wa barakAllah fiqh.